Hi Aries, welcome back to my channel. This is Abby and I am an intuitive reader. So we will be doing your monthly reading for the month of October 2023, and it could span across from today all the way to the next 3 months. Alright? To the new viewers, welcome to our channel. To the current subscribers, thank you for your support on our monthly readings. And as you know guys, I already had my surgery few weeks ago and it was successful, so I'm recovering really well, thank God. Okay, so enough of that. So for your month reading, we will be looking into the general life snapshot. So we will be tapping into the current energies surrounding your situation right now for the month of October. New beginnings. What do you need to give to yourself, to others, to the community? Some lessons that you have to learn or you have yet to learn. And manifestations, what do you need to release and what do you need to keep doing? Okay, so for the second part of that reading, after that, we will be looking into your love spread. Alright, so let's begin. Let me just shuffle again the cards in front of the camera before we start the reading, alright? So, hi Aries! So, let's start your general life reading. We will be getting 7 cards for you and then we will clarify each card's if needed. All right, so here you go. Okay, so this is your first card, your second card, your third. Later on you will see this third card in front of the camera if it's not visible. Okay, okay Aries, let's open all your cards first before we start your general reading. All right so your first card, you have the Major Arcana, Temperance, and then you also have the Ten of Wands. Third position, you have the Queen of Swords. Interesting energies. And then at card number 4, you have the Six of Pentacles, Ten of Cups, Knight of Cups. Interesting. And you have the Page of Swords. So you're starting off with a Major Arcana at position number 1, Temperance. So there is something here that you're trying to be moderate. Okay, you're trying to mix some sort of situation here, or finding your balance or rebalancing a certain area of your life. Okay, so let's clarify the Temperance since this is a Major Arcana for our collective Aries. Okay, so your Temperance card is clarified by another Major Arcana. So it's the Devil's energy coming here, Capricornian energy. All right so there is the situation you need to release. It's a connection. Okay, so from the get-go, it's a connection with someone that seems very toxic and unhealthy. Okay, you have this connection with them, but you know, when you have a strong soul connection with someone, okay, it's purely happiness, you know, love, understanding. But for this case, what you need to release about the connection or this connection, okay, is the energy of being attached or obsessively attached to them, drawn to them in an unhealthy way. All right you somehow feel like you're strongly bonded with this person, but this is for reasons that, you know, you cannot escape, like world paradigms or belief system. It could also be like an addiction, or you know, just a cycle that keep on repeating, which actually are hurting the both of you or the connection. Okay, so that's basically what you need to release in your life. Okay, I'm sensing it's a connection or a situation that's been toxic and draining the both of you, or it's been unhealthy or not giving you what you deserve, or it's not actually helping you to reach your best potential. It could also be a work situation that you need to temper. Maybe it has been too toxic or stressful for you, your colleagues, but for some reason you cannot escape the job because, you know, you just need a job. And it's hard to find a job these days, especially in my country where there's so many people looking for a job, but the opportunities are not enough. You know, if you study economics, okay, so it's like the law of supply and demand is not balanced, right? So that's the thing here. There's something that's not balanced in your life right now that you kind of feel like you want to exit or escape from it, but it's just that your only way right now is to handle it with care, handle it in moderation, right? You also have this job or business venture that could have, you know, draining you for hours, for days. You're lacking sleep. You know, it could also be like maybe you're overindulging in parties, in drinking, you know, anything that's not serving your holistic wellness, all right, Aries? So you need to release that. Or if you're not ready to release, then slowly detach from it, okay? Whatever is that situation, you could be like wanting to detach yourself from smoking. So it's not an overnight change, okay? You need to slowly detach away from that if you want to keep yourself healthy. You know, these things, just an example. Alright, so take whatever resonates. Now, for what you need to continue doing is to keep on holding on. Exactly what Avril Lavigne's song says, okay? Because you have the Ten of Wands in position number 2. There is this situation in your life where it's really overbearing, or just you cannot take anymore, but you keep on hanging on. You keep on trying to make it work. And you're not ready to give up too soon. Okay, let's see. What you need to keep doing is not to give up too soon on to a situation and trying to fight for it, okay? Whatever it is, let's clarify the Ten of Wands for Aries. It could be in your career, stability, security, you know, money, financial situation. Recently you're trying to get yourself together about certain areas of your life, you know, trying to make both ends meet in situation or a particular area of your life. So it's a general life snapshot. Anyway, it could be anything. So let's clarify the Ten of Wands. Ten of Pentacles. It could be struggle about money, like I said, a home situation also, like you felt like your household situation, your marriage life, your commitment life, your work, your endeavors lately, your money, okay, your savings. I think it's being put to test, I will say, okay, that commitment, that material possessions being put to test right now, and you're finding it hard to work on it. Like, it's been difficult lately in your life. Maybe it has something to do also on how to get more financial stability in the family. All right, so but it's only a matter of time, guys. Don't give up, because the advice here is that this is on your what you need to keep doing, okay? Do not give up. Try to use all their means and the resources. Try everything that you can do to save a commitment, a relationship, or property or resources that you have right now, because it's only a matter of time, then you will finally get out of that difficult situation. All right, now what do you need to manifest? You have the Queen of Swords, Aries, and now let's take a look what the Queen of Swords has in store for you, because this falls under the manifestation here. So Queen of Swords is a Libra energy, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini energy also. So it's the time for you to be more strategic, plan ahead, okay? Don't make any decisions or impulsive decisions for the month of October all the way to, you know, end of the year. I would, you know, advise that, okay? This is a short-term prediction. Let's clarify the Queen of Swords. These are your manifestations. Everything that you are thinking of right now, you need to approach it in a logical way, okay? And there should be, you know, some sort of a process here or discerning, okay? You need to carefully thought about certain actions before making a decision. Okay, what is this Queen of Swords? You have the Three of Wands. Yeah, there is something here that you need to patiently think about or analyze or investigate, probe, okay, learn before making your final decision, because you know the Three of Wands is like a waiting game, okay, and you're waiting for something to happen, but you already make a decision which path you want to take, because the Two of Wands is about opportunities, you know, you're stuck in a crossroad, and finally you made that decision, probably to travel, to go places, to make a change in your life. But this is something that you need to think of. Don't make any impulsive decision, okay? Make sure that it's in alignment with what you think will be best for you, okay? So there is some kind of like planning involved here, okay? Before, maybe if you're considering to migrate, it needs a lot of time planning about how to migrate. You need to consider the country, the location, some legal papers, you know, everything that's, you know, logical and something that has proof before you make a decision. Like even on business ventures, everything must be in gray and white. You need to have a feasibility study of some sort before starting a business. These are just examples. So the advice here is that be wise and be more discerning, like weigh the pros and the cons, because Libra are about scales, okay? Just make sure that pros and cons or the risk is not that high, more than the benefit, more than what it could benefit you, all right? So that's in your manifestations, okay? Now for the surrounding energies, you have the Six of Pentacles here. So let's take a look, what is the Six of Pentacles? It could be like you are not receiving what you really deserve lately in life, okay? You feel like you've been robbed, you know, someone could have one-upped you or robbed you or steal something from you, you know, these things. You felt like there's some kind of energy of scarcity, like you need some balance or fairness in material realm, okay? So let's clarify the Six of Pentacles for Aries. Okay, Aries, you have the Knight of Swords. All right, so the Knight of Swords have this energy of you know, someone's rushing in for truth, for information, for communication that's honest and truthful. So I think for the surrounding energies this October for you, Aries, you have to be upfront about what you deserve, okay? You have to tell people that I felt like there has been some imbalance about the energy or the time, the effort that you're giving to each other, okay? You have to be open about fairness and equality also in the workplace. You need to start opening up about certain things that, you know, you need to protect also yourself. Make sure that you are not being on the disadvantaged position. It could apply to your business partners, to your colleagues, even in your family situation here. Like even in our family or in a relationship, there could, we could, you know, we could feel like being left out or outsider. So you have to be open about communicating what you feel is like something is not fair, all right? So it's more like to me an advice to you for the month of October. Now what you need to give to others is the Ten of Cups, and the Ten of Cups is like your ultimate happiness, okay? Probably this is a period of time also to make other people happy, to start a family of your own, to be more loving and nurturing. But let's see, what do you need to give to others? Please clarify the Ten of Cups for Aries. Let's take a look. Aries, the Ten of Cups being clarified by the Chariot. Okay, so it's finally about time for you to give yourself what you deserve, the happiness that you deserve. All right, don't get stuck in a rut. If you felt like there is this connection trying to hold you back, or certain situations that preventing you to be happy, to fulfill or to reach your best potential lately, like I said, whatever situation is this that you cannot escape, it's been draining you. So make sure that you're handling your energy, your time and resources really well. You're managing really well. Don't let it drain you or succumb to the energy of someone's, you know, depleting you. All right. So it's about time to give yourself the happiness that you deserve, and you need to find it. All right. It could also be like there is some sort of progress lately in your life about a commitment. Okay. It could also be signifying that someone's finally making a huge shift on a connection or a commitment that could lead to having, you know, your 10 of cups, like a family. You could probably be settling down, getting married, okay? You could also be like, you know, traveling somewhere with your family as well, okay? And when it comes to your business and your financial situation, I think if there will be some great progress there, if it's something to do with your material realm, it will be more stable, not only stable and secured, but you will be contented and fulfilled, all right? Whatever it is going to have this big changes, movement forward, okay? And that's what also you need to give to yourself, because I think that you could be depriving yourself from the things that you really deserve in material realm and in emotional well-being as well. So don't be afraid to be happy. Don't be scared that you will not fulfill the dreams that you want for yourself, okay? One area of your life will truly make you happy. Could be a commitment, it could be, you know, stability, security, having a family, in the material realm as well, okay? It's not that I think this is the kind of happiness that cannot be bought, okay? Cannot be measured by money or a opportunities, right? It's something to do with your heart, okay? Your heart will be full. That's what you need to give to yourself. If you need to give yourself a break, then that's good. There's some movement or changes here that will make your heart full of love. You will feel emotionally contented, right? So choose whatever resonates. Now for your new beginnings, you have the Knight of Cups. So the Knight of Cups signifies love offer, love interest. So there could really be someone, although this is a general life situation, I felt strongly that there is some sort of connection, you know, with energy that's coming in a romantic way for this reading. So the Knight of Cups signifies love, interest, proposal, potential romance coming in for you. It could also be some people trying to fulfill your heart's desire, like, because with what you are going to give to yourself, something big change that could fulfill your emotional needs, okay? It will really make you happy. I could see that, okay? So let's clarify the Knight of Cups for our collective Aries here as your new beginning. So Three of Swords, so your new beginning, after a heartbreak, it could be a love interest, okay? It could be new, it could be an existing person here. But I felt like after a heartbreak or a heart loss, you know, we could have a heartbreak in any area of our life, at work, with our colleagues, with friendship. No, I think there's this relief that's coming in, like a peace offering or a reconciliation or a message to suit you, like to please you, and that apology or the return of someone or an offer of a love interest or a romance could actually heal your heart for some reason. It will help you to forget your heartbreak and disappointments from a past person, or it could be a current person as well, but they will be coming better, okay? They will be coming in a lot better compared to who they are in the past, okay? Now for the Page of Swords, there's some sort of communication lessons learned here. So I felt like it has something to do with communication lately, or checking out or being investigative, because you are in the Queen of Swords energy, and then there's this Page of Swords and you have the Knight of Swords. So I felt like there will be some sort of like a communication here, okay? Like improving a communication, improving the you know, trying not to block or be open to receiving news and information, okay, and truth from other people. But let's see what is the lessons learned here. You have the Page of Swords as lesson, so let's take a look for Aries. Okay, you have the King of Cups. So all right, so Aries, I felt like there will be a communication coming in from a very loving energy. Like, it's like a confession, or because the King of Cups, they don't really normally, you know, express how they feel. They keep it to themselves, but they're very emotionally mature. Okay, it could be a new person, it could be an old person, all right? Maybe if you will, they will come in, this communication will come in from a person that's emotionally mature, emotionally stable, okay? And I felt like the lesson here is that I think the problem here as well has something to do with the way a connection or a situation or communicating with each other. Okay, I kind of sense like maybe there's this, you know, avoidant or detached or harsh energy when there's this communication or news exchange between people, a group of people, you and other people, like a family situation or a lover, you know, or friends. Okay, so the lessons learned here is that when we communicate, we need to communicate, we need to be honest and truthful, but at the same time it should be more, you know, loving. Try to put some emotions to it, or expression of, you know, you're coming from a place of compassion and understanding. Okay, that's the way I feel about the general life Snapchat for you, Aries. Now I hope it resonates with you, and then let's move on to your love spread reading. Let me shuffle the cards again in front of the camera and I'll get back to you in a bit. Hi Aries, so we will be doing your love spread reading. So let's get 5 cards for you and clarify each card before we start the narrative of your situation. Alright? Okay. 5 cards for our collective Aries. Okay, let's open your cards first. So you have Aries, your first card, you have the 6 of Wands, Knight of Swords again. Okay, this card actually appeared in your first spread. You have the 5 of Pentacles, Aries, 3 of Wands again. Okay, and last card, you have the King of Pentacles. All right, let's clarify each card before we dive deep into your love situation, Aries. Okay, so your Knight, your 6 of Wands rather, is clarified by the Empress. Okay, from the Knight of Swords, clarify again by the Devil card, Major Arcana. It also appeared in your first spread. Your 5 of Pentacles, clarified by another 5. Okay, I felt strongly connected to your first spread. So, 5 of Swords, 3 of Wands, clarified by the 9 of Swords. King of Pentacles, clarified by the 6 of Swords. Alright, so you're moving on from the King of Pentacles. It could be Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well. I'm reading this as a court card. Okay, it could also be like you're moving together with a person, because this one has a family. It doesn't matter, sometimes some 6 of Swords card have this single person in it. Okay, it depends on the illustration, that's all. But what I'm getting here is that you're moving on to better times, to have a good life somewhere. Okay, like I said, there's this sense of traveling involved, or migrating, exploring the world together, with or without your person. But it's like the better situation here that you're thinking or you're feeling is actually something that's more stable and secure, especially in the material realm, something that's solid, like a commitment that someone could give to you. Okay, that's what you're trying to move forward to. All right, because there was this, you know, trust issue lately. The connection maybe has been distant and cold between the two of you. Someone could have left you or reversed the situation here, abandoned you. Someone could have been orphaned, you know, in a family situation as well. It's like the foundation now is being shaken up. The domestic situation or the living in situation, you felt like it's starting to crumble because of arguments and fights, because 5 of Pentacles, impoverished. No, there could also be like an argument, you know, know, problem in finances, problem in the commitment. It could also be an issue about, you know, two people having a lot of fight and quarrels and arguments or misunderstanding lately, okay? So probably someone could have walked away because they felt like they're defeated by this person all the time, like they're always right and they're always wrong. Like this person could have probably also gaslighting you, projecting everything to you that what you did is actually wrong when in fact it's not. So I felt like there's this kind of energy, like someone's trying to feel like they're always right and you're always wrong for some reason. That's something to do with communication. Like I said, the communication between this connection has been very harsh. The living in situation or the connection, the commitment is being affected by this, because I felt like it could be someone here is quite arrogant and cold and detached emotionally lately in the connections, because you know it's swords and you see this five of pentacles, baby. It's cold outside, like someone that's, you know, is, you know, push you away or like left you like with no shelter, with no proper care. You know, it's the opposite energy of the queen of pentacles. Like someone should be taking care of you, but it's the other way around. They left you, they abandoned you, they cannot provide for your needs, okay? Emotional needs as well. And it's also affecting your mental space, because you could probably be repeating over and over again the situation with you. It could be harsh because there's this Knight of Swords here, and the problem in this connection is that you cannot really escape, okay? For some reason you are bonded with them, with children, because you have the six swords here with a family. And you see here three people involved in an argument. You could also be trying to meddle with the connection, you know, like a third party influence. Doesn't have to be a third party situation, or they're in another commitment. Doesn't have to be like that. I felt strongly that there is this external influence here that could probably, you know, the reason why there has been some issue lately in the connection. I feel strongly has something to do with money as well, and the security and stability and the communication. It's actually the main reason why the two of you are always on misunderstanding. Someone could be very honest, hurtful, truthful and blunt here, but somehow you cannot escape this connection, even though it's very unhealthy already, okay? So the thing here is that you could also be, you know, impregnated again, okay, in the coming months, okay, next 1 to 3 months time, by someone here who's just really basically enjoying a good time, okay? It could also be like a perfect time for this person, or for you to actually give this relationship a chance, okay? For some reason you have the Empress, and Empress is about, you know, conception, trying to look good, you know. Could probably be impregnated by this person here, but it's just that this connection is, you know, there is this energy of someone wanting to get the attention here. So they're trying to be attractive, they're trying to lure you, but this someone could be, you know, egotistical, if that's the correct word here. Like they're full of ego, they like attention. They could, since this is once, this person could be quite arrogant. They like attention from other people. They could be, you know, trying to get your attention again, okay, to start something new with you, all right? But just be careful. But I do see, you know, how at the beginning and the ending could be promising, and at the middle, that's what happened actually, okay? So I do see that there might be some second chance or a reconciliation here coming from this person, okay? And the important thing here is you could probably moving to better times with them, to a more stable and secure place, because from the five of pentacles you are transitioning, or this person will be able to provide everything that you want. They will try to nurture and take good care of you this time around, all right? So I hope that resonates with you, Aries. I see you guys on the next month reading. Take care, God bless, love you guys, bye.